to rewrite sort of a mixed up thing. You just have to feel it.
There was nothing to do but play, you know, and we had a lot of fun trying to play, you know.
It's hard to explain.
Plenty of jam sessions.
It's just hard to describe. It's hard to explain. Everything you cannot explain. Just if you're good, then you don't have to play.
Plenty of jam sessions, but basically speaking, much poverty.
Blues, everybody play the blues, and have them too.
As a result of a certain musician applied to a certain instrument, you get a definite tonal character.
We wish we could take you inside, but nobody's allowed in while they're rehearsing, you see.
You're gonna be thrown right out.
Now that's all there is to it. Even if we wanted to go in there, we couldn't because the security is so tight. Any unauthorized individual going through that door will be forcibly ejected. Now that's all there is to it.
Everybody with the buttons down. we have a saying in New York that says to, when in doubt, just bogart, which means just take charge. So that's what I usually try to do.
Thank you. fear for Bob. Just play it once. Wayne to come in for the second time. Then I'll play the middle with him. And y'all play that other, play the, go back to the other key and play that by yourself. Alright?
Thank you.
things that I play. Morrissey, remember when you played this? He remembers all of it. I can't. When I hear it, I said, oh, you know, it's like I'm another person.
Come on. Thank you. Everybody needs to get their heart broken a couple of times. That way, when they get the real thing, they appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? Thank you.
Thank you. Joe sample. It was 1954, 1955. I'm either 15 or 16 years old. The place is somewhere in a barn with a bandstand along the East Texas and Louisiana border. We are in sugarcane country, approximately 200 miles from my hometown, Houston, Texas. I am the piano player in a band, the house band, the road band. We are the put-together band, Country Towns. These blues artists could have been Gate Mouth Brown, T-Bone Walker, Big Walter, Little Walter, Johnny Copeland, Percy Mayfield, or any number of those particular men that were prominent at that particular time. The custom was the band played a warm-up set, and of course the singer finally comes on to the bandstand, and then the show commences. We, of course, wanted to play our jazz. We'd do anything to play jazz, and we would force jazz over the top of these rhythm and blues. Suddenly, men would start walking from the back of the room and approach the bandstand. This man said to me, "Look, I want you niggas to understand something right now. We paid 25 cents at the front door, and we came in here to have a good time. Now it sounds to me you guys are playing a bunch of bull, and we're not getting our money's worth. So we're going to tell you now. We will take your instruments from you, whip your ass, and destroy your vehicles. And more than likely, you will have to walk and beg your way back to Houston, Texas. Now, we will do this to you unless you make us feel real good, real suddenly. So, of course, this is the supreme method and technique in the learning of how to groove. I became an instant groove master, as so did all of my buddies on the bandstand. This is a tale of development along the Texas-Louisiana